Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. A young woman from Dover was taken to Maine Medical Center with serious injuries after crashing her car in Maine early this morning. Police say she was driving the SUV when it went off the side of a road in Lebanon, Maine, rolled over several times, and unearthed a large stump. All five people inside that SUV were injured. No one was wearing a seatbelt. There is outrage this morning in a Manchester neighborhood after a city plow driver knocked over dozens of mailboxes over the weekend. Sometime late Sunday night, the plow mowed down boxes on Stonington Drive, Meeting House Lane, and other nearby streets. More than 20 boxes in the neighborhood were knocked over. We spoke with Director of Public Works Kevin Shepard. He says it's not uncommon for mailboxes to be damaged during winter plowing, but he's never heard of this many being hit in such a concentrated area. Neighbors are looking for answers.
That's a tough job, and it was late at night, and if it was one off, it would be okay, so he hit a mailbox. What was kind of odd was the fact that there were so many that got hit. I think you've probably been around the neighborhood. There's probably dozens.
That plow operator is currently off duty, and the highway department won't know more until supervisors are able to speak with him when he comes back to work this morning. The public works director says the city does plan to replace the damaged mailboxes with standard wooden posts and boxes. The trial of a man accused of setting a deadly fire in Keene more than two decades ago is expected to wrap up today. David McLeod is facing four counts of second-degree murder in the 1989 deaths of Carl and Lori Hina, their four-month-old baby, and Carl Hina's 12-year-old daughter. McLeod is accused of killing the family after prosecutors say he set fire to their apartment building. Closing arguments in his trial are expected today. If convicted, McLeod could face life in prison. The Hooksett School Board is scheduled to vote tonight on a proposed 10-year contract to pull its high school students out of Manchester schools and send them to Pinkerton Academy in Derry instead. Late last year, Hooksett declared Manchester in breach of its school contract, claiming the schools in the Queen City are overcrowded. However, Manchester school officials are threatening legal action if Hooksett tries to pull out of the deal. A recent move by former Massachusetts Senator Scott Brown is fueling speculation that he may be considering a run for Senate here in New Hampshire. Brown told our political director, Josh McKelvin, that he has accepted an offer on his Wrentham, Massachusetts home. Brown currently has a vacation home in Rye, and that will be his new permanent home. Beyond that, no decisions have been made, but Brown has said in the past that he is intrigued by the idea of running here in the Granite States. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.